And there, you have to admit that it is true that you guys have been branded as a party that doesn't care about ordinary working people. That's it may not be fair, but it's true. You're against minimum wage increasing. You're against you cut the unemployment rates, unemployment benefits right before Christmas, and wouldn't put that in the budget.
Democrats didn't vote.
And the president signed it.
Okay, I'm not arguing about the merits. I'm just saying I think it's true.
The perception problem.
What are you going to do about that?
Well, I think there are a number of folks within the Republican Party who are doing a very good job of changing the Republican Party profile on this. If you go back and you read the speech that Paul Ryan gave during the campaign out in Cleveland, where he talked about the need to change the way that we talk to people in the inner cities, how it is that we understand that economic opportunity is going to be built not with a top-down government approach, but with a bottom-up approach that does that gives people the skills they need, that gives people the economic opportunities that they need to rise up the economic ladder, and that's how you fundamentally change some of the income disparity problems that we see in this country. I think just proposing a minimum wage hike is not going to do enough, and that's
going to do something, and it's the fairness.
Well, for example, what do you believe? What do you believe we should raise the minimum wage to?
Well, you know, I would start with $9.
Why not 12? Why not 12?
I would go to $10.
Why not 12? Why not 15?
Well, because I've read studies where people said that at that $10 to $11 range, you've got enough small business support. But you still make a significant difference.
If it's going to solve problems with people's incomes, why not make it 15? Because there's a trade-off to the economy. When you raise the price of employment, you have less employment.
No one's saying that, but that's not an excuse not to do anything.
But why not? If not 12, why not 15?
Because you're just being outrageous now.
No, because you won't.
That's a legitimate question.
Because what I want is a concession. What I'd like is a concession. That there is a trade-off on that when you
there
do
is a
that,
trade-off at some point.
But
I think the reason the president the reason the president picked $10.10 is because that's what the minimum wage would be if had there been a cost escalator since the last time it was raised. That's why he picked it. Mm-hmm. Is there a trade-off? Yes. Is there a trade-off at that level? Probably not.
But let me just ask you this, Hillary. Income inequality, even though it's an important issue, has historically not been a vote mover. Yeah. It just doesn't get people out to the polls. So I'm wondering if this is the Democratic big idea for 2014, raising the minimum wage. Is in a low turnout year, is that really going to get people out of the house?
Look, I don't know if there's any one thing. And I think that you're right on one point, which is, look, this could very easily go into a class warfare discussion, which will not help Democrats.
Right.
Because essentially, and it's never helped in politics, because people want to feel aspirational. They want to feel like they can move to the next socioeconomic class. But we've had such a stilted movement over the last 20 years that people have stopped dreaming that way. And so I think what they do want to see is our politicians and our elected officials actually making an effort to understand what they're doing. So to just simply say, no, that's not going to work, forget it, that's not going to work, is not going to help. That's why where I feel like Democrats trying to put stuff on the table, trying to get out there, the president getting out there, talking about this is going to be a political game. Sure.